everyone, Sky Cosplay here. Today's video is going to be a little bit different in that I am actually going to be doing a wig review on a wig that I bought for my 02 cosplay, which I'm obviously wearing right now. I just wanted to talk a bit about this wig just because I had a rather interesting experience with this wig here that I am wearing. And I just wanted to give my full thoughts and, you know, if anyone is curious about buying this wig and what to know about it, because I have a lot to say about this wig. And by a lot, I mean a lot. Now, okay, so first things first, I bought this wig from the website Lucile, I have no idea how to say their website name. They're a Chinese wig provider. I've actually bought wigs from them in the past. This is actually my third wig from them, and the other two wigs that I purchased through them, I absolutely had no problems with. I got my Asuka Langley wig from Evangelion. I bought that wig through them, and I also got my sister's Judy Hopps Zootopia wig through their website as well, and both those wigs have been absolutely amazing. But for some reason, this wig here wasn't quite so easy as my Asuka wig or my sister's Judy Hopps wig. So, first things first, I'll get to the actual price of the wig. Now, this wig was on the website advertised at $20. Now, that is quite cheap for a wig that is this long and of this quality. However, once you convert it over to New Zealand dollars and the shipping, which was like an extra $30, this wig came to about like $60 or $70, give or take. I can't remember. It was like either $60 or $70 from memory. So it was quite expensive, but I was like, you know what? I've bought wigs from these guys before and they've been absolutely amazing. I still like my Asuka wig I got in 2016 and I still have it now and it is still really good quality and still looks amazing. So I was like, you know, I don't mind spending this much money on this wig because I know it will be good quality. So yeah, the price was quite a bit, but I was happy to pay it. Shipping didn't take that long. It took maybe like 2.5 weeks or something like that, maybe even less, I can't really remember, but it didn't take that long. Even though I picked the most cheapest shipping option, which was the China airmail, it still arrived like really quickly and I was quite pleased with the shipping time. And the wig, I'll show you right now, so the wig arrived in this plastic bag, which is kind of interesting because usually wigs that I get, they come in like little Ziploc bags where you can keep the wigs in, like that's where I store my wigs. But this one came in this plastic and I had to, you know, rip it open to get into it. I mean, it was fine, but it was just interesting because I hadn't seen this kind of sort of packaging before. The wig also came with a hairnet, which I've lost, but it's okay, I've got tons of other hairnets. But yeah, packaging was interesting. But yeah, it came in this plastic bag, had a hairnet, and I don't think it came with a wig cap from memory. No, I don't think it did come with a wig cap, but that's not a problem because I've got loads of wig caps and they're like $2 anyway, so it's like not even a problem. So yeah, that was all fine. When I took out the wig from its plastic initially, I was like really impressed with the quality. It looked absolutely gorgeous. I love the color of this wig. It is the ideal pink that I wanted for 02's hair, and it looks lovely. Like, I really love it, and it looks really pretty. Really nice quality, and I was like running my fingers for it. I'm like, this is so soft. It felt really, really nice, and it looked really nice. So then it came to the part where I was going to style it. So the wig's bangs came to about like just here on my nose. So they were a bit long, so I trimmed them to the best of my ability. I'm like no wig styling expert, so I was like Yeah, still learning myself, but I'm actually quite happy with how the bangs look. They're not perfect, but I'm happy with them. So I trimmed the bangs, that was all fine. And then, as I was going to take the wig off, I noticed there was a massive knot on the bottom of the wig. Which I was like, okay, there's a knot, I'll just gently comb it out. I use a thick ridged comb to brush all of my wigs, and this comb was really great. I like use it on pretty much all my wigs, and so I started combing it out, and as I was combing it, the knot wasn't getting any smaller. It was gradually getting bigger and bigger and bigger as I was combing it, and I started to get a little bit worried because I was like, what's going on? None of my wigs that I've ever had have never done this before. Like, I've had knots in wigs, but I always managed to comb them out. This one just kept getting bigger and bigger and bigger, and it was turning into a bit of a monster. It was kind of scary, and I was getting really, really stressed out, and it got to the point where I was like, right, like, combing it obviously is not working. I need to, like, back away and sort of rethink how I'm gonna fix this wig. So by this time, this wig was an absolute nightmare. This wig was an absolute nightmare. Like, I was like internally screaming. So I decided to leave the wig in fabric softener overnight because I watched some videos on YouTube of like what to do if your wig gets really tangly. So I was like, okay, I'll leave it in some cold water and fabric softener overnight, and hopefully that will make it easier for me to detangle the knot the following day. So I did that. Took my wig out of the fabric softener and the sink that I left it in, and it wasn't any better. In fact, I think it was probably worse than what it was, and yeah, I was like really stressed out. I tried to comb it again with my wig comb, and it just wasn't getting any better. It was getting worse and worse and worse, and I'll insert a picture. Yeah, this is what the wig looked like. It was absolutely horrifying. And I was like really upset because I spent like 70-ish dollars on this wig and it's doing this. I mean, it's probably, part of it's probably my fault, but I had only been wearing this wig for like an hour and it had already gotten that knotty. Like, this was just around the house and it had resulted into this. So yeah, I was like freaking out and I was quite upset. So I just left the wig, I put it aside, and I basically got in contact with a fellow cosplayer who was really, really nice, and she actually managed to fix this wig for me. Otherwise I wouldn't be wearing it right now, basically. I would have thrown it out and probably cried and then spent a lot more money on another wig. But yeah, she was awesome and she actually managed to revive this wig. She actually had to cut a whole load of it out because it was actually like a dreadlock. It had actually like clumped all together into this massive ass dreadlock, and it was so bad. Like, the rest of the wig was fine, it was just one part. So yeah, but it got fixed and it looks really nice, although I'm still personally terrified of this wig, because I don't want that to happen again, because that was really stressful. But it's been put in hair conditioner, so hopefully it shouldn't tangle as badly. Like, this wig actually has tangled a little bit as I've been wearing it now, but I've been actually like able to comb through it and like brush the tangles out. Like, they haven't been as nearly as bad as what it was when I first wore this wig. Like, it's been really easy to brush the tangles out, so I'm hoping it will stay nice and easy. Because, yeah, this wig was an absolute nightmare to deal with. That being said, this wig is really pretty. And it's a real shame that, for some reason, the fibers or whatever, there's something weird going on with this wig. I don't know if it was just this wig that was like this, or Luke Kyle, whatever, they've changed how they've made their wigs. But I mean, I've got wigs from them before, they've been fine. I don't know what's wrong with this wig. Maybe it's because it's so long. I don't know. I feel like it probably shouldn't be like this, but it's made a lot differently than other wigs that I've had through them. Like, the fibers like fuse together for some reason, and it's really bizarre. So basically, if you want a nice 0-2 week for photo shoots, maybe get this one, because this wig is actually really nice and it does actually really look good in photos, but to wear to a convention, I probably wouldn't recommend it. And I don't know how I'm gonna deal with this at the convention. I don't know, I'll have to see how I go. I will probably still get a new 0-2 wig anyway, but I don't really want to spend the money right now because I've already spent so much on fixing this wig and buying this wig and just everything else alone. It's been like really expensive. But basically, if I had to give this wig a rating out of 5 stars, I would probably give it like 3 stars out of 5. It would have been like, I would have given this like a 5 out of 5, or you know, a 4.5 out of 5 if it weren't for the fact that this wig tangled so badly. So yeah, it's a real shame that it was like this. But yeah, basically if you want this wig, do not wear it for conventions. I'm not entirely sure if it was just this one-off, like this was a one-off wig, or all these 0-2 wigs are like this. I don't know. I personally wouldn't risk it. But you know, if you want to wear this for photo shoots, then that's probably the way to go. Because it does look really nice. Like, it is really pretty. But that is pretty much the majority of what I have to say about this wig. it's a real shame, but what are you gonna do? I will probably buy a new wig in the future, but we'll have to see. So thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope you like this little cosplay wig review, and I hope this helps you guys if you're looking for a 0-2 wig. I suppose this is what not to get if you're thinking of getting a 0-2 wig, or if you are and then you just want to wear it for photo shoots, then maybe this is the wig for you, but who knows. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed watching this, and I'll see you in my next video. Goodbye.